And I'm Ashanti Muhammad.
And we're with Jack and Jill TV.
We have the report of a lifetime. Jack and Jill family from the sweet, sweet southeastern region, while the North Star to Canada.
What's the North Star? It's the star that guided slaves on the Underground Railroad to freedom.
Today we learned all about their hard, courageous journey. The first stop on our ship was the last for the slaves on their way to freedom, Detroit, Michigan.
I follow the North Star.
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 Some glad morning when this life is over, I'll fly away to a land on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away. Whoa, I'll fly away. Oh, glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Just a few more weary days and then I'll.
At the Charles H. Wright Museum of African American History, we feasted on the beautiful surroundings and wonderful food.
Fly away, oh, I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away.
As a special treat, we heard from the great statesman, abolitionist, and orator, Frederick Douglass.
Education was and still is the key for African Americans to improve their life.
Fly away, Lord, Lord, I'll fly away.
Wouldn't let us take pictures, so we don't have any footage of our experiences at the museum, but we don't want to spoil your visit to the museum.
The And Still We Rise exhibit took us on an amazing journey that began with the wonders of Africa. Then we saw how Africans became captives and were taken through a dungeon. They were eventually taken onto a ship where they were placed in chains and packed together for months.
Detroit played a crucial role in the Underground Railroad as the last stop in a journey that took months and sometimes years for fugitive slaves.
There was slavery in America, where if you was a slave, everything you owned, you could put in a handkerchief, because that's all you had.
We went on one of the stops on the Underground Railroad, the First Congregational Church of Detroit. The church is a living museum where actors take you on a real adventure to freedom.
Detroit was known then at that time as Midnight. Well, it was named Midnight because that was the last stop before they headed over to Canada.
Our North Star trip took us on a detour that did not exist during slavery, the fantastic Motown Museum. It turned out to be a favorite stop for many of us. Still has the original name on it, Hitsville, USA. We had a chance to sing all the great classic Motown songs as we learned about the legacy and the legends who helped make the music industry what it is today.
Before us, we followed the North Star to Canada. Just think, all it took to get to freedom was to cross the Detroit River. How they must have felt. They didn't go through customs, but we did. Then we traveled through Windsor, a city in Ontario, Canada, and eventually we arrived in Chatham. They call it Canada West. The area is mostly farmland, the same as it was back when the slaves came here.
Next came the biggest treat to our visit, the 87th homecoming celebration in Buxton. Buxton is the only settlement for free slaves that still exists in North America.
Welcome to Buxton. People, welcome to my hood. Welcome to my hood. My name is Chris. Chris Prince. I grew up here. I'm like the seventh generation. No further ado, man, it is my privilege, my honor to introduce to you guys Mr. Christopher Paul Curtis.
I'm originally from a city right here called Flint, Michigan. And what I'd like to do is tell you a little bit about Flint, and a little bit about my writing, and then we'll talk a little bit about Buxton. You have
lost!
You said you lost.
Mr. Curtis kept us fascinated and laughing for more than 2 hours. He even read from Elijah of Buxton.
Don't get spooked. Most times when new free slaves come to Buxton, they get helped here by an Underground Railroad conductor. But every once in a while, they find us all on their own. When that happens, someone usually spots amongst the trees or bushes, stealing looks and studying us hard.
Here's where he signed my book. What an experience. Went to two churches in the Buxton Elgin settlement, the Pioneer Church and St. Andrew's.
We'll be asking somebody through our children's story, maybe that you can share a little bit about what the Jack and Jill is all about.
Precious Lord, take my hand.
Buxton is a very small community, close.
Let me stand.
Next, we visited the site of Uncle Tom's Cabin.
I am weak, Lord, I am worn.
The final stop on our trip proved just as fascinating as the rest. We visited the Chatham Kent Historical Society.
Some glad morning, when this life is over, I'll fly away to a land on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away. Whoa, I'll fly away.
We follow the North Star. Yay!
And we follow the North Star. Now you have too. I'm Ashanti.
I'm Amir.
I'm Anala.
For Jack and Jill TV.